I felt like all the way through his movements, his body was, you know when someone goes from double unders on you and you like go steady like a ball? Like he does that like all the way through trying to move it before the screen grips. So he always has a wrist control, he always hits a head grip, and he has a stiff like a board body until he hooks the stuff up, and then only at that point does he look into like punching.
So basically, it's always a trade-off, right?
Frank, just to quickly reiterate.
Yeah.
So from here, if you feel a difference and not letting me get a try,
because of my current state, it's not so much about me trying to
get off. You go to the wrong side, use your legs to push and power assist with your hands. So you've got your legs and your hands fighting that, and then you're cinching in so he can't bring that elbow back out. Now you can switch it back with the head control to the Cool. Then if he really like has it all the way out, so now you definitely can't pull it across. That's when you can if you come back to this position and you can't push it across. Now you can still hook the triangle up, but try and push back instead. So you get him to try and hook that up, that's it. So now this artery is open, you douche back him. Yeah, just put it on the arteries and squeeze. That's usually, so it needs to be like, let's see his arteries here, there you go. That's it, shut that arm, he'll tap. If he defends, it's just going to flip this arm off. And you pull it across.
But I need the muscles there to support my
So and the other option, if he's round the thing, is the TP as well.
Does that feel like a choke?
It did, it's like you aim just below the ankle.
I put the piston that way, like that.
I'm going to come and train because I'm not
So the turn you're in action,
I'm not rolling.
On the TP, if
you're
being
you reach behind and grab like an S grip, and you squeeze your legs. But the same thing's happening in every case, you see what I mean? Like it's all just cutting those off, and that's what the focus is. So you can do that in loads of different ways, but you just have to, and the more ways you've got to do that in, the more dangerous your triangle is, the more options in that guard. Definitely. I'm sure I've been modified by the foul.
And I guess I'd probably then start trying to defend it. Like, do that again?
And it's light to get the heart rate going, but also
that's when you could then.
You could wrist lock from any of these as well. There'd be all sorts of deadly wrist locks from these positions where they can no longer extract their elbow and you could two-handed crimp on his wrist for a brutal wrist lock. I honestly have to do shit like that all the time. Yeah, exactly. And then now he can't withdraw his elbow, right? So it's just sitting there. Like, so there's all kinds of, and all of that's going to create panic that will let you get these again. See what I mean? So like, there's all kinds of different wrist locks. There's this way, there's inwards that way, there's in this way as well, and all of those are going to help open up those different options too. So don't forget, like, you just have to make them panic. It doesn't even have to be real, the wrist lock. They just have to be like, oh shit, he's trying to wrist lock me, and they make a mistake with the elbow.
So fear of the heart.
That's what he was saying, stiff as a board, because all those defences become like harder to do, because he's lifting more of your body weight. Like when you're down, he's got like most of your body weight on the floor and he can tilt your hips.